Hi girls, this is Miss Genossi here, probably know me from dance. I'm going to be partial support for Year 7 for the coming weeks, so if you have any problems or anything, feel free to email me or obviously Miss Harbert as well or your form teachers. If you get any phone calls home from me, it's not a cause for concern, you're not in trouble, it's just for me to check up and make sure that you're doing okay. If you need any support at home or on Teams or with your lessons, then I'll be there to help you, okay?
Girls, and welcome to our assembly. Today we're talking about e-safety. We're using computers and phones all the time now at school as well as for pleasure. You need to look after yourself and keep yourself safe. In real life, we don't choose to be friends with everybody. We don't have to on social media either. You don't let anybody into your house. You don't have to let anybody into your social media. Please listen carefully, watch this with your parents, and take note and act responsibly.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Let me tell you a story from God's Word. One time, Jesus was teaching, and some people came up to him with a question. They said, "Hey Jesus, what's the most important rule that God ever made?" And so Jesus said, "The greatest and most important rule in all of God's Word is this: love God with all your heart, all your soul, and all your mind. And here's the second most important rule God ever made: love other people as much as you love yourself." In fact, Jesus said that those two rules were so important that every other rule in the Bible depends on them. Wow! So loving God and loving other people must be pretty important for Jesus to say something like that. But how do you do that? Let's start with your mind. Your mind is important because everything you put in it is gonna affect your heart and soul. That's why you have to be careful about what you put in your mind. The Bible says not to have a mind like the world, but to renew your mind. One of the best ways to do that is to read God's Word as much as possible. You can also use your mind to learn about what God is doing around the world.
Hello, Year 7. As you may know already, my name is Demi, and I'm delighted to be your head girl and very much looking forward to getting to know you all this year. As a part of the Earthshine community and a member of the student leadership team, your physical and mental well-being are very important to us, as we want you to feel as though our school is a safe place where you can get the most out of your education. As well as this, we believe that it is just as important to stay safe on social media, because if you don't use it carefully, it can become a scary and dangerous place. Remember never to talk or respond to strangers, as a good Ursuline student only stays in contact with her friends and family online. And most of all, make sure you report anything you find suspicious to an adult that you trust. Keeping things to yourself will only make you feel worse and not resolve the situation. So be smart online, and if you think carefully, you'll be fine.
Hello 7U and the rest of Year 7. Just a quick message from me to say that I hope you're all well and that you're managing learning from home as best as you possibly can. I'd also like to say a massive well done to the students who got involved in the challenge I set on the Keeping Active During Lockdown Teams page. I will be posting another before the end of this week. So it would be great to see as many of you get involved with that as possible and keep active as much as you can during this lockdown.
Hi Year 7, Miss Lake here. I hope you're all well and keeping safe in these difficult times. I hope you enjoy today's assembly. It's always important to keep safe online, and if you have any concerns, then speak to your form tutor or another member of staff, and we're always here to help.
Socialising online can be lots of fun. Just stay smart about it. Use the same rules that you use when you're out in the real world. And when you get that message on your mobile phone, just remember, it may not be the person who you think it is.
There are so many different ways of connecting with friends, but some websites have age restrictions. Check the website's terms and conditions to check if you're the right age to use it.
Never arrange to meet someone you meet online, no matter how well you think you know them.
It's worth remembering that everybody's different. What you find funny, someone else might not. Always treat people the way you want to be treated.
I have no friends online. I'm not sure how safe it is. I sometimes feel pressure from peers to go online, but I've decided it wasn't for me.
I have lots of friends online. I all know them in real life, so I don't talk to anybody that I don't know. So I don't have any friends such as Justin Bieber out of nowhere. In my opinion, just be really safe.
You may have heard the word or phrase digital footprint. You might not know it, but whenever you do something online, you leave a footprint of wherever and whatever you're doing. Once you leave this footprint, it's almost impossible to get rid of. So while putting your pictures and videos online can be a great way to express your creativity and share with your friends, there's no such thing as a secret online. And once it's on the internet, a lot of that stuff is gonna be there forever. It's worth remembering that when you post something online, you are potentially sharing that with billions of people all around the world. Imagine your grandma sitting behind you. What would she think? Just think before you post.
Stop whatever you're doing and listen to me. This is of the utmost importance. You look beautiful today.
So, well, first of all, I wasn't raised Catholic. I was raised Protestant. So I became a Catholic later on. And I was at a youth group, and then I met Sister Elvira Maria, our superior here. And she spoke with such a love and joy about her life as a sister. And it really grabbed me and didn't let go. So a year later, I dared to write her and to come down and to see for myself. And well, then I went for a day and for a weekend and then another weekend and then another weekend. And at the end, I just knew this is the thing I have to do. This is the place where I belong. This is where I can love Jesus, be with Jesus and give my life for him. And that's the main thing, you know. You, as a sister, you marry Jesus, you love Jesus, and you give your life for him.
You should know why you should be kind online. Do you realize that being kind online is very important? Why does everyone think Mia is awesome? Here's one reason She always says hello to everyone with a big friendly smile. Mia is smart, and she knows it's important to treat others how she would like to be treated. You probably know that too, but you also know that good manners and kindness are just as important on the internet as they are in the real world. People with whom you talk to or play with on the internet have feelings like your friends in the real world. That's why it's important to be friendly with people online. And when everyone is respectful and nice, it makes the internet safer and more fun for kids like you and Mia. Mia is playing a game on the internet with her friend, and she is winning. Should she tell her friend, "You are not smart enough for this game," or should she just encourage her friend to play better? If you think Mia should encourage her friend, you are correct. You don't want to be called mean or a cyberbully. That's why you should choose to be kind and respectful. The other player might be good in another game, and you never know, she might just encourage Mia next time when she isn't playing well. You see, being kind is the best way to be liked by your friends and stay awesome on the internet.
Alex. Yo, Alex.
Alex.
Jesus be.